In the previous video, you learned how to assign a tag or a symbolic name to addresses you're going to use in your PLC program. Then, I wrote some simple code to energize the main contactor. In this video, I'm going to continue writing this PLC program to be able to control a three-phase motor using a star-delta starter. Okay, as I mentioned in the previous lesson, the way that this star-delta starter should work is that when the start switch is pressed, both the main and star contactors are going to be energized at the same time. And then, after a few seconds, the star contactor will be de-energized and the delta contactor is going to be energized, all while the main contactor stays energized. So first, the main and star contactors are energized, and then the star contactor de-energizes while the delta contactor energizes. With the current code, I'm only able to energize the main contactor. But when the main contactor is energized and the motor starts, I need the star contactor to be energized at the same time to control the inrush current. To do that, I'll click on New Network on the toolbar to add a new network. Then, click on this line and add an SR flip-flop. With this flip-flop, I'm going to energize the star contactor, so I'll assign the address of this contactor for the flip-flop. As I said, the star contactor should be energized at the same time as the main contactor, so I'll add an open contact in the set input of the flip-flop with the address of the main contactor. With this code, as soon as the start switch is pressed and the main contactor is energized, this open contact will be closed and energize the star contactor as well. So when I press the start switch, both the main and star contactors are going to be energized. The main contactor flows the power to the motor, and the star contactor connects the right side motor terminal together and sets the connection in star. Now, this star connection should last only for 8 seconds to reduce the inrush current of the three-phase electrical motor. After that, the star contactor should automatically be de-energized, and the delta contactor should be energized at the same time. When you need to turn on or off something automatically in your PLC program, one of the best tools that you can use is a timer. To add a timer, in the Program Elements window, you can open up the Timers folder. Here, as you can see, there are 5 different types of timers that you can use. The type of timer you use in your PLC program depends on what you want to achieve in your program. For instance, here I need a timer that is able to de-energize the star contactor after 8 seconds. That means I need a timer that is able to do something for me automatically after a specific amount of time. For that, I can simply make use of an on-delay timer. The way that this timer works is very simple. Here, when the set input is true, the output is going to be true after some delay. The amount of time that the output delays depends on the time you enter in the time value input. Now, there are 2 types of on-delay timers in Step 7. Normal on-delay timer, which is what I currently have here, and retentive on-delay timer. The retentive on-delay timer works the same way as the normal on-delay timer, but the only difference is that for this timer, if the input goes false while the timer is timing, the output stays true. So for the normal on-delay timer, if the input goes false, the output will go false as well. But for the retentive timer, if the input goes false, the output will stay true. I'm going to use a retentive timer here, so I'll delete the other one. These red question marks here show that I need to consider an address for this timer. The addresses that you can use for timers in Step 7 start at TO and usually continue up to T255. I'll assign TO as an address for this timer. As I said, I need this timer to de-energize the star contactor after 8 seconds. So, I'll add an open contact in the set input of the timer with the address of the star contactor. By doing this, as soon as the star contactor is energized, the set input of the timer is going to be energized as well, and the timer starts timing. I want this timer to be energized with an 8-second delay, so I should enter 8 seconds here as the time value. The time value should be entered in S5 time format. That means, in Step 7, when you want to enter the time value for the timer, you simply need to add S5T pound before the time value. For instance, when you need to enter 8 seconds as the time value, you should enter S5T pound 8S. For 10 seconds, you need to enter S5T pound 10S. Okay, so with this logic, when the star contactor is energized, the set input of the timer is going to be energized. And since this is an on-delay timer, it will be activated after 8 seconds. On the other hand, I want the star contactor to be de-energized after 8 seconds, so the timer can definitely help me with that. How? For that, I can simply add an open contact in the reset input of this flip-flop with the address of the timer. Now, as soon as the timer is active, the star contactor is going to be de-energized, and that's how I can de-energize the star contactor automatically after 8 seconds. With the current logic, in the first network, when the start switch is pressed, the main contactor will be energized. At the same time, in the second network, this open contact will be closed and the star contactor will be energized. When the star contactor is energized, in the third network, the timer starts timing and after 8 seconds, it will be active. Now, since I have the open contact of the timer in the reset input of this flip-flop, as soon as the timer is active, the star contactor is going to be de-energized. So with the PLC program that I have here, when the start switch is pressed, both the main and star contactors will be energized. And after 8 seconds, the star contactor is going to be de-energized automatically. Now, let's go to the next lesson and continue writing this PLC program. Many of you have expressed that this is the easiest lesson learning environment that you've come across. We've heard many of you expressing how much you're enjoying this content. If this is your position, please communicate your appreciation of our videos with a like. The more likes we get, the more enthusiastic we are to continue to provide this content in the future. So show us your love now and like this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. That way, each new video will be sent to you as it's published. In addition to the likes and subscribes, make sure that you head over to realpars.com to find even more training material for all of your PLC programming needs. We offer many videos to assist you in learning PLC programming and landing that job in the high-paying, highly sought-after field of automation and controls engineering. Go to realpars.com and subscribe to our highly effective training series now. Your future awaits.